generations to come, children will be told a story. They'll be told that once upon a time, Europe was divided. There was a big wall down the middle of it, and the people in the East were very poor, and they had no democracy, and they lived under an evil system called communism that killed millions of its own people. But joy of joys, the wall came down, and we finished up with 27 nations, and those people lived in democracy, and 500 million people lived in peace. But sadly, no, there is more. I promise you there's more. Thank you. I should just sit down now. Well, I must say, that's the first time I've ever received such applause, and I am tempted, Mr. Verhofstadt, I am tempted to sit down. But if I may, sadly, the story continues. The politicians in charge became very greedy, and they wanted money for themselves, and they wanted power. And so they resorted to lies and deceit, and they staged the most spectacular bureaucratic coup d'etat that the world had ever seen. But they didn't need to use any bullets to do it. They were much cleverer, much more scheming than that. No, what they did is they put in place a new treaty. It was called the Lisbon Treaty. And then, they gave 27 people total unlimited power. These would have been the people that made all the laws. Of course, they already had a flag, and they already had an anthem, but they went about building a new state. But they ignored the people. And what they did, whether they knew it or not, is they recreated the very evil system that the people in Eastern Europe had lived under before. But the incredible thing was, the people, the new bosses, had also worked for that same evil system before. Well, of course, the plan was wrong. And then vegetable companies came for that. But still, the new bosses wouldn't listen to the people. No, yes. They made life tougher and tougher. They put tens of millions into poverty. They denied people a say. And in the end, those people had to resort to violence to get back their nation states and their democracy.
Thank you.
The moral of the story is they had learnt nothing from history.
Thank you, of the European Mr. Parliament, President.
Before you give this commission power, remember
thank
that
you,
60
Mr.
years
President.
Ago, an iron curtain came down on Europe.
Thank you,
but now,
Mr. President.
With this commission, there is an economic iron fist,
yeah.
And it's being felt in Greece today. We cannot.
Thank you. Thank you,
Mr. President. Thank you very much. Thank you,
Mr. President.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.